Assalamualaikum, my name is Widi Mutakin. In this video, we're going to discuss how we can organize materials inside 3ds Max and creating our own library so we can access them easily anytime we need them. Using this method, you will gain significant speed in your workflow when adding materials into your scene. This will become even more important if you are working together with a team. And the good news is that we're not going to use any plugins at all. So everything you need is already inside 3ds Max. Before we touch materials in 3ds Max, the first step to organize your materials is actually organize your texture files. Why? Because most of our material will be using textures, right? So it's only makes sense to organize your texture files first. To organize your textures, you can use folder structure which categorize the textures in logical hierarchy. What I mean about logical is that try to organize them from broad to specific category. This technique or method of categorizing information is called taxonomy. The broad category will be at the higher level folder hierarchy, and the more specific the texture type, the deeper the folder hierarchy should be. Each person usually have their own way of categorizing things. So this is all up to you to decide. If you have no idea on how you are going to categorize the textures, just open websites which provide texture such as cgtextures.com. You can learn how this website categorizes the texture, and this will be a good starting point for you to develop your own. After setting up the folders, the next thing you need to do is to name those textures appropriately. For this, you need a good naming convention. For example, naming a texture file like this image will be brick rounded yellow 001div.jpg. For the div, it actually stands for diffuse color. For a bump map version, you can use this name brick rounded yellow 001bump.jpg, so on and so forth. Now, I am not going to dictate you how to set your naming convention. It's all up to you or your team. After your textures is well categorized in good folder hierarchy and already using good naming convention, the next thing you need to do is to register all of those texture folders into 3ds Max default path. So later, 3ds Max will never lose the links to any of your textures. This is important, for example, when you create a new texture and put the texture inside the existing texture folder structure, 3ds Max will automatically able to locate it. Okay, so to register all of your texture folders, let's just say that all of them are inside a parent folder called texture library. Now go to customize, configure user paths, external files, and click this add button in here. Select the root folder for all of your textures. And this is important. Make sure that you check this add subpaths down here. So every subfolders inside your texture root folder will be registered also. I actually already done this, so I'm not going to do it again. But I'm sure you get the idea. Next, we're going to learn how we can create a material library inside 3ds Max. A material library is actually a special file which contains information about materials and their parameters. The extension of material library file is .mat. For example, to save these three materials that I have in here, simply click this Get Material button. This will open up the Material Map browser window. Right-click in here and choose New Material Library. Notice 3ds Max will prompt us to save this to a new .mat file. We can save this to our own library folder dedicated for material files only. This is a good practice, for example, if you are working in a large team and your team are using versioning system such as Git, you can track the material folder for changes from time to time and sync them with the rest of your team. Okay, let's name this new material library Flat Pastel Color, just for example. I will delete this later on. The material library will manifest as a panel in your material browser. Notice this minus sign in here indicates that there is no material in this material library yet. To add this material to that library, simply click drag from the material editor to this panel. Again, you can put this on top of the other or below it. Now, pay attention to this asterisk sign up here. This sign indicates that there are changes happening in the material library, but we haven't saved it. So this sign, although small, but play a very important role. To save the material library file, simply right-click, hover to this URL, and click the Save button. Now, as you can see, the asterisk symbol are gone, and we just save the file. Sometime, we want to override a material, and sometime, we also want to remove a material from a material library. To override the material, for example, we can make changes to this purple material, and we want to save these changes to the material library. Simply hold and drag again on top of the old one until you see these red lines appear over the old material. Just release the mouse button. Now our material is already overriding the old one. But you need to save this again as these changes will be gone if you close 3ds Max without first saving the material library file. To erase a material from the material library, simply right-click and choose Remove. Now the material is gone. Again, just like before, you need to save the material file to make the changes permanent. When you have a lot of material library going on in your material browser, at a certain level, it may confuse you. To reduce this kind of complexity, we can close the material libraries that we don't need at the moment. We can close the material library by right-clicking on the material name, and then choose Close Material Library. Closing material libraries will not erase them from the hard drive, and we can always load them at later time. To load material library files to our material browser, we can right-click again in here, and then choose Open Material Library. Then choose the .mat file you want to open. And after we do that correctly, we will have the material library in here as a new panel. To use these materials in our scene, you need to drag this to the material editor and use it like any other materials, such as we can assign this to an object, for example. The last thing we're going to discuss is previewing our material so we can see them more clear. As we can see, our materials in here looks very small. To make the icon bigger, we can right-click on the material library's name, then go to Display Material Library as, choose Large Icon. Now we can see the materials much better. That is all. If you like my tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to get updates to my other future tutorials. I usually add video once a week, sometime even twice a week, inshallah. Thanks again for watching, and I hope this tutorials is beneficial for you. Wassalamualaikum.